ब्लैक बॉडी रेडिएशन एंड प्लैंक्स क्वांटम थियरी. दिस प्लैंक्स क्वांटम थियरी विल एक्सप्लेन अस द पार्टिकल नेचर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशंस. Here, this wave nature of light or electromagnetic radiations will explain such phenomena like interference, suppression, amplification, etc. But this theory was unable to explain certain things like emission of radiations by hot bodies. That means, for example, if iron rod, if we observe, it will be in some metallic luster or black color. When you heat it, gradually that black color will turns to dull red. On increasing of temperature, that red color will brightens. That means the intensity of the color will increases as we increase the temperature or increasing the heating of that iron rod. On further heating at certain temperature, it becomes bright white color, just like the flames that were observed in magnesium. On further heating, that flame color will turns to blue color. That means when temperature increases, the frequency emitted by that body will also increases. That we called as a radiation by the objects. And another important phenomena is photoelectric effect. Photoelectric effect means when a wavelength, a light radiations, that is electromagnetic radiations with specific frequencies are focused on the surface of a clean metal surfaces, certain active metals like potassium, rubidium, cesium, they will emit electrons due to the falling of radiation over their surface. So that effect is said to be photoelectric effect. Photoelectric effect means the ejection of electrons by metals due to the projection of this electromagnetic radiation over their surface. So that phenomena is said to be photoelectric effect. So such things were not explained even by electromagnetic theories. Now, to explain these things, a new theories were proposed, particularly this black body radiations. Black body is an imaginary body. An object which can absorb all types of electromagnetic radiations and wide range of electromagnetic radiations completely is said to be a black body. Black body is an object which can absorb all types of electromagnetic radiations, because some metals will absorb white light, some metals will absorb green light, some will absorb infrared radiation, some will absorb ultraviolet radiation, some objects will absorb far infrared, some absorbs X-rays, some absorbs gamma rays, some absorbs radio waves and microwaves and so on. But no object can absorb all types of radiations. But scientists are imagining an object It's an just like an imaginary object. No object in this universe is a perfect black body. The definition for a black body is an object which can absorb all types of electromagnetic radiations completely. That means a black body is a perfect absorber. It's not only a perfect absorber, the black body should emit the whole radiations what it has absorbed. Actually, such object is not present in this universe. Thus, it is an imaginary. As a teacher, I have an intention that my student should absorb whatever I deliver. And he should be in a position to reproduce the same what he has learned from me. But it is not possible. Now you are in the class. You can give me or deliver me the important content that was delivered to you, but not word to word, what I have was explained cannot be repeated by you, just like a tape recorder or a video recorder. You cannot deliver. The important points you can deliver. But in my opinion, and in my ambition is, my student should deliver everything just like a tape recorder can deliver whatever that was recorded. It's not possible. So here also, scientists, in the view of scientists, an object which can absorb all types of radiations and which can emit the whole radiation what it has absorbed is said to be a black body. But such body is not in this universe. But a halosphere means a sphere which has halo in its surface, inside. And inside walls are coated with platinum black, having a small hole, will act as a nearer black body. A halosphere, coated platinum black inside, having a small hole, will act as a nearer black body. It's also not a perfect black body. Now, so to explain the radiation of this black body, Max Planck proposed a theory called as Planck's quantum theory. According to Max Planck, the emission or absorption of radiation by a black body is not continuous. According to Planck, the emission of radiations is due to the vibration of charged particles on the body. Vibration of charged particles means the electrons. Due to the vibration of electrons or the displacement of electrons from one place to another place, the radiation will emit it. The emission of these radiations are not continuous. The emission of these radiations are not continuous, but in the form of small energy packets called quanta. Small energy packets called quanta. The energy of this quanta is capital E. The energy of this quanta is capital E. This energy packet, which contains certain quantity of energy, which is called as quanta. So the emission of energy is in the form of a small energy packets called quanta. The energy emitted in the form of quanta is immediately propagated in the form of waves. That means energy, releasing of energy is in the form of quanta, in the form of energy packet. But the propagation is in the form of a wave. Almost, if it is a wave, it will have frequency or wavelength and so on and so. So this energy E and the frequency of the radiation that during the propagation is directly proportional, that is directly proportional to nu, or E is equal h nu, where h is known as Planck's constant. H is known as Planck's constant. The value of this Planck's constant is 6.625 into 10 to the power minus 27 erg second, or 6.625 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. Once again, according to Planck's quantum theory, the emission of energy by an object is due to the vibration of charged particles, that is electrons. The emission of energy by an object is not continuous but discontinuously in the form of small energy packets called quanta. The energy emitted in the form of quantas is propagated in the form of waves. So this energy of the quanta capital E is directly proportional to the frequency of that wave, that is E is directly proportional to nu, or E is equal h nu, where h is a constant known as Planck's constant. The value of the Planck's constant is 6.625 into 10 to the power minus 27 erg second, or 6.625 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. This is regarding Planck's quantum theory. This theory explains the particle nature of electromagnetic radiations. Now, Einstein generalized this theory, which was proposed by Planck to explain black body radiation. Einstein generalized this theory for all types of electromagnetic radiations. That is Einstein's generalization. Einstein's theory, or Einstein's generalization for Planck's quantum theory. Einstein generalized Max Planck's quantum theory. Max Planck proposed his quantum theory to explain black body radiation, whereas Einstein generalized Planck's quantum theory to all types of electromagnetic radiations. There is only a slight difference between Max Planck quantum theory and Einstein's theory. Einstein proposed that emission of energy by an object, or emission of radiation by an object, is due to the vibration of electrons. The emission of energy is not continuous but discontinuously in the form of small energy packets. This was also the idea of Planck. But he proposed the energy packet is called as photon. Not proton, it is photon. P-H-O-T-O-N-E. So energy released in the form of small energy packets called photons. The energy emitted in the form of photons is propagated in the form of photons only. Till this energy was absorbed by other object, the photons will not lose their identity. This is the basic difference between Max Planck and Einstein. According to Max Planck, only emission of energy is in the form of energy packets, but propagation is in the form of waves. That means absorption is not in the form of quantities. But Einstein said both absorption and emission is in the form of quantas, is in the form of energy packets. That means quantization is followed during absorption as well as emission. The absorption of energy is also not continuous. The emission of energy is also not continuous. Both absorption and emission are discontinuously in the form of small energy packets called quanta. The emission of energy is never be continuous. For example, we have a tube light or a other light, whatever it may be, one in an object which gives light radiations. We think that light is coming continuously from that. But it is not so. The light emitted by is discontinuously in the form of small energy packets. That light is not continuous, but it appears to be continuous. That because of the error in our sight. For example, I'll tell you, if you go out for a movie, you will observe certain actions that were made in the theater. That means a hero comes and fight or dance, whatever the action that may be. You feel that the process is continuously going on without any interruption. But if you go to the projector room and observe the film, suppose if one hand was lifted like this, in this duration, here one photograph will be taken, in this place another photograph was taken, in this place another, in this place another. So the action of 1 second was recorded on 24 frames. So these 24 frames was rolled in the projector with high speed. That is, in 1 second, these 24 frames will be displayed on the screen, by which we are appear it to be, it is continuous process. But actually it is not continuous. Our eye can observe the action which takes more than 1/17 second. That means if you roll only 14 films per second or 10 films per second, you can easily observe the change of one frame to other frame. If more than 17 frames were changed in 1 second, you cannot observe how many the continuity in this. So our eyelids will open and close. You know, you'll close your eyes and open your eyes, close your eyes and open your eyes. So the image which was recorded previously will present on the inside our brain. During that time only, you see that we both are seeing one together continuously, but it's not so. Your eyelids are closing. But that superimposition of these figures, it seems to us that we are continuously looking one another. Just like that. The emission of energy by an object is never be continuous, but discontinuously in the form of small energy packets called quantas or photons. So the basic difference between Einstein and Max Planck is, Max Planck explained only the emission in the form of quantas, whereas Einstein proposes that both emission and absorption is in the form of quantas only. So he used the term photon instead of quanta. So according to Einstein, the energy emitted by the object is due to the vibration of charged particle like electrons. That energy packet is called as photons. The energy emitted in the form of photons is propagated in the form of photons only. That means photons will not lose their identity during their travel. Even it is a particle, it will have certain wave motion. That's why that energy, suppose for example, an object at excited state E2 when reaches to ground state E1, it emitted an energy equal to both the difference of both energy levels, that is delta E. Delta E is equal to E2 minus E1, that is equal to h nu, which was given by Planck only. Here also h is known as a constant, which is said to be Planck's constant. This E2 is the energy of an object at excited state, E1 is the energy of the object at lower state, lower energy state or ground state. So the difference of these two states will be emitted in the form of photon, and that photon energy delta E is equal to h nu. Here also h is known as Planck's constant. The same h value is 6.625 into 10 to the power minus 27 erg second, or 6.625 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. So, this is regarding Einstein's theory of general.